Good morning, everyone. You're very welcome back to Age and Opportunity's Movement Minutes with myself, Paul. I hope you're all having a nice Wednesday so far and you're ready to join us for our standing session today. For today's session, all you're going to need is yourself, a good space on the floor around you, and also if you wish to add into your resistance today, I'll ask you to grab small weights, so we can the actual weights themselves, bottles of water or tins of fruit, which I have here as well. So I'll give you a few seconds just to grab those. Good morning, Jerry, and I'll give people time just to get in and join us this morning. And also, if you think maybe that you're not that confident standing on your own, you can use a chair or any external support such as a wall or a mantelpiece as well, just to give you that extra bit of confidence. And as a final thing is just to have a glass of water nearby as well, just in case you need it. So we're coming in there thick and fast. We have Mary. Mary's joined us there as well. Jerry's already in. So great to have you in here, folks, and joining us here this morning. So just before we begin, I'll ask you just to place just your feet just slightly wider than shoulder width apart. Slightly bend the knees and then just place your palms or the backs of your hands just back to back. Okay, I'll ask you then just to close your eyes. And as always, we're going to begin with three deep breaths. So we're going to breathe in through the nose, lifting the hands up high above the head. And exhale, hands down. Inhale, hands up. Exhale, hands down. And final one now. Big deep intake of breath, hands up over the head. And exhale, hands down. And when you're ready then, you can slowly just begin to open the eyes. Good morning, Kathleen, you're raring to go. Great to hear. I wouldn't expect any less from you now at all, Kathleen. One of our many regulars. So we're just going to begin, folks, with our warm-up. So just starting off nice and easy, just marching on the spot. Gently lifting the feet and just lifting the heels off the ground, okay? So the knees are coming up towards us, just one at a time, nice and easy. And what I'll get to do that is just step from side to side. Okay, so if we can, our heels are touching, side to side. And as we're doing this, even for the smallest of split seconds, we're just balancing on one leg as well. Okay, so over and back. And as we're doing that then, we can try and multitask. We can just tap each of the tips of our fingers off the tops of our thumbs of either hand. So just over and back, just nice and easy. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Great stuff. Back to just marching on the spot again. Alright, and what we're going to do, assuming you have a clear space behind you, we're just going to take 1, 2 steps back and 1, 2 steps forward, okay? 2 steps back. And 2 steps forward. Just in and out. Good morning, Elizabeth. You're very welcome in and thanks for joining us here this morning. And as we do that, so we have our 2 steps forward, 2 steps back, and we're going to open and close our hands as we do that. Okay, so we're opening on the way out, close on the way in. So 2 steps forward, 2 steps back. Open out the hands as we go forward and close them in then as we come back. And we're going to go for 3 more. Last 2. And last 1. All the way in. And all the way out. Great stuff. We're going back to our side to side. So we're moving on a few planes this morning. We're going forwards and backwards and side to side. And as we are going side to side now, I'll ask you just to bring your fingertips just up to meet your shoulders. So again, just nice and easy, just swaying from side to side. Elbows tucked in by the body. And we're just bringing the fingertips up then, just up to meet the shoulders. For 4, 3, 2, and last 1. From there then, I'll ask you again just to firmly plant your feet on the ground. A slight bend of the knees. I'll ask you just bring your hands together in prayer. Okay, our hips are pointing forward. And what we're going to do, we're just going to twist the body around to the side and hold back to centre and a slight hold at the side and back to centre again, okay? So we're just gently moving from side to side And we're twisting just the mid region or the torso of the body. And we're going to go for 4, 3, 2, and last one. Great stuff. Using your external support then, whether it be a door, a closed door, a mantelpiece or a wall, I'm just going to use the chair here. And we're just going to gently just swing the leg back and forth, just like a pendulum, just nice and easy. Just swinging it out. We're going to go off the right leg first. 3, 2, and 1. We're going to swap over then to the opposite leg. So again, just having your hand there for support. Just nice and gently, starting off small, and then you can increase the angle as you go on then for 4, 3, 2, and 1. I'll ask you then just to face your support, and we're just going to swing it out to the side, just nice and easy. Again, starting small and gradually increasing the angle for 3, 2, and 1. We're going to swap it over now to the other side. Just across the front of the body and then reach it out to the side for 3, 2, and 1. Great stuff. From there then, again, using your external support, you're going to lift up the knee, hold it, and place it back on the ground. Okay, so lift it up, ideally in line with your hip, no higher. But if you can't get that high, that's okay as well. Place it back on the ground, up in line with the hip. And down, we get two more, last one, and back down, and last one now, just up in line with the hip, and all the way down. We're going to change it now to the other side, lift up, just in line with the hip, and down, up, and back down, and we're going to go for two more, that's it, and last one, and back down. Great stuff. Last one now, just to warm up the ankles, I'm going to ask you just to point your toes in the ground, and then what you'll do, you'll just slowly rotate the ankle around. Okay, so nice concentrated circles. Okay, we're getting the full circle if we can, and then we're going to go in the opposite direction for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. We're going to swap it now over to the other foot. Same idea again, we're just going to roll it around for 3, 2, and 1, and the opposite for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. And we're just back into marching on the spot now. Okay, and I'll ask you now if you're ready, just to grab your weights if you have them nearby. If not, you can still join in. All you're doing is just using your hands instead of holding weights like so. Okay. So what we're going to do, starting off again, planting the feet nice and firm, just to give ourselves a nice strong base. And we're just getting an overhand grip of our weights, and we're just bringing them up the shoulder height, no higher, and slowly back down, okay? So just up as high as we can go, and slowly back down. And we're going to concentrate on the breathing now, so we're going to breathe out on the way up. And we're going to inhale on the way down, okay? So out on the effort. And in on the way down. Great stuff. That's it. And we're going to go for 4, 3, 2, and last one. Great stuff. Bring it back down. We're going to concentrate down the front of the body. So we're going to bring the arms up in front, both at the same time. Again, up in line with the shoulders, ideally, no higher. But if you can't manage that, just bring them up as high as you can. And again, we're going to breathe out on the way up. And inhale on the way down. Okay, so a big exhale on the way up on the effort. And inhale on the way down. Great stuff. 3 more. 2. And last one, excellent. From there then, we're going to go back to our first movement, which was arms up by the side, and we're just going to add in a heel dig in front. Okay, so we're digging one heel at a time, just out in front, not too far. Just a gentle dig in front. And the arms are going up then at the same time as well. Okay, so we're just adding in an extra bit of work. We have the arms going like before, and then with the feet moving as well. Okay, so it's a full body movement. And there's a bit of coordination in there as well. Last 3, 2, and last one. Great stuff. And our final one now. Again, we're coming back to our raise in front. So the raising the hands way out by the front. And what we're doing as well, again, another bit of coordination with the feet. We're going to point the toe out behind and stand up nice and tall. Point the toe out behind and stand up nice and tall. Okay, so we're reaching out as far as we feel comfortable. And again, that's going to be different for each and every one of us. So do what you feel comfortable doing. And again, if you find the weights maybe too much in this, you can leave them down like so, and you can just add in the arms themselves. Alright, and we're going to go for 3 more. Last 2. And last 1. Great stuff. We can grab a drink of water out. And remember, at any stage at all, even if you're doing this live, if you need to step out or you need to grab a drink of water by all means, and join us back in when you're ready then. Okay, if you're watching it back, I suppose you have the facility there that you can pause it, and you can join back in then again when you're ready, okay? You don't have to do everything I'm doing. Just do what you feel comfortable doing. And if that means stepping in and out, so be it. Okay? So we're going to move on now to our next set of 4 movements, okay? So we have 4 sets of 4 movements. This is the second one now. And we're just going to start off just nice and easy. Again with our weights. And we're just going to have them by our side. Okay, just nice and relaxed, arms hanging by the side, not too tense. The arms are straight. And what we're going to do, we're going to step out in front. And we're going to bend the back knee and the front knee just a bit more than they're bent at the minute at the same time. Okay, so that means the back knee is going to lower and the front knee is going to go straight ahead. And then we're going to push back off the front foot. Okay, so that again, step out. Bend both knees, they're going to go in different directions. Your back heel will lift, and then you're going to push back with your front foot. Okay, so stepping out, bending the knees, and pushing back. Out, bend, and push. Great stuff. And again, just a slight bend here, now nothing too dramatic. And our starting feet position then are, if you imagine yourself on train tracks, okay, so about shoulder width. You're going to step out in front, bend both, and push back, and you're going to change then, so you're going to alternate every time. You're going to push off the left, and then you're going to lean with the right, and push off the right, and you're going to alternate over and back. Okay, we'll get one more off each, so pushing out, and pushing back, and stepping out, and stepping back. Great stuff. You can shake out the legs there now. And if you have a chair nearby, just grab it if you feel that you need it. Okay, you may not, you may be happy enough to do this movement without the chair. So what I'll ask you to do again is just an overhand grip of your weights. Place them just in front of your lap. And what you're going to do, you're going to sit down in the chair or you're going to squat down. Okay, so we'll show the squat after. Just for now, we're going to sit. So we're going to stand up nice and tall, pushing the weight through the heels. And we're going to lift the weights up to our chin, pointing the elbows out. Lowering back down, and then we sit down, okay? So we're standing up, zipping up our coat, zipping down the coat, and sitting back down, okay? If you want to try that without the chair, what you can do, again, you'll zip up as you stand up, zip down, and you can sit down into a squat and come back up. Okay, so up to the chin, back down to the lap, squatting down, standing up, zip up, and zip down. Okay, so whatever you feel most comfortable doing, you can do it without the chair or with the chair. Okay, I prefer to do it with the chair. It just gives you a guide of how far to go. So zipping up, zipping down, sitting down, standing up, and zipping up. Okay, so we'll leave that there. We can place the chair to the side for the time being. What we're going to do now, we're going to do the reverse of what we did before, stepping out. So this time we're going to step back. Okay, so we're going to point our left big toe out behind Slight bend of the knees. Again, that back knee lowers towards the floor. And then we're going to stand up nice and tall. Toe behind. Bend both knees. Stand up nice and tall. So we're just, again, we're alternating the foot behind. So we're going to go the right foot first behind. And stand it up. Left foot. And stand it up. Okay, and then our starting position again are those train tracks. So just the width of our shoulders. Standing up. Back. And up. And we're going to go for three more. Last two. And final one. Great stuff. We can grab our chair again. Just place it by the side if you need it. Okay. Grabbing our weights this time, we're facing the palms or hands away from ourselves. And what we're going to do, we're going to take the weights up towards the direction of our shoulders. And we're going to twist our hands. And we're going to reach as high as we can overhead. And bring it back down. And back down to the side again. Okay. So curling up to the shoulders. Twist the hands. Press up above the head. And back down. If you feel it's too difficult to get it up above your head, what you can do is you can curl up towards your shoulders. And push the cans out in front away from you. Pull them back in. And take them back down. Okay. So curl. Push. Pull. And back down. Or curl, push, pull, and back down. Great stuff. Okay, so you can place the weights to the side for a second. Just give the hands a quick scrunch. Okay, just because we've been grabbing them now for a while, you may feel the fingers of the hands maybe a bit tender. So you can scrunch them out. And then we'll move on to our next set of four. Okay, we're going to need the chair again for this one. So again, two variations of this. We're just going to have our weights by our side. And the first, an easier variation, is we're just going to sit down into the chair. And we're going to stand up nice and tall again. Okay, so back down into the chair. And pushing the weight up through the heels. Or what you can do it without the chair as well. So again, just weights by the side. You can squat down. And stand up nice and tall. Okay, so we're going to get to the bottom, or as far as you can go. You can pause for a second, and stand up nice and tall. Okay, so just taking the chair out of it. And we'll go for three, two, and last one. Great stuff. Okay, you can shake out the feet. And what we're going to do now, we're just going to step out in front. Okay, so right foot out in front. Left foot flat behind, and what we're going to do, we're just going to box one at a time out in front, okay? So we're boxing across the body, so left is going to right, and right is going across to the left hand side. So we're just reaching across, just one hand at a time, nice and steady. And again, we're just working the arms here, but we're getting the heart rate up as well. Great stuff. And we're going to go for four more. Three, two, and last one. We can stand it up nice and tall again. Just again, relax the hands by the side. And we're going to go back to our chair now for our next movement. Okay, so starting from the seated position, we're going to hold both our weights, our hands out in front, just in line with our shoulders. And as we stand up, and again, be mindful to push the weight through the heels, we're going to lower our hands by our side. And then as we sit down, we're going to bring our arms up and stand and sit and stand. Okay, so as we go down, our arms come up, and as we stand up, our arms come down. And we're going to go for three, last two, and last one. Great stuff. So that's a great movement there again for getting up and down in the chair. Strengthening the legs and also balance the coordination as well. The fact that you're adding the arms as well. And our last movement there, this block, we're just going to step it out in front. We're going to hold the weights just in front of our shoulders. And what we're going to do, we're just going to reach high above the head. So instead of boxing out like the last time, we're going to box high above the head. So just reach it all the way up, one at a time, and we're just, instead of this time, or this time, sorry, instead of the last time, we're just going straight above the head. We're not crossing over, so again, just straight above the head, so boxing all the way up. I better watch the light here now, so it's just right in front of me. That's it, last four, three, two, and one. And finally now, just two quick small movements just to finish off. The same ones that we started with. So we're just bringing it up to the side for five, four, three, two, and we're going to hold the last one up now. We're going to hold it for 5 seconds. Four, three, two, and one, and we're going to lower it down. Great stuff. And the final one now, I promise this time, we're going to bring it up in front for five, four, three, two, and the last one we're going to hold for five, four, three, two, and one, and slowly bring it back down. Great stuff, folks. Great work. You can put the weights away now. You can put your bottles of water or your tins of beans, whatever you have yourself there. You can pop that away for a second. Grab your water now. If like me, you're feeling a bit thirsty, keep yourself hydrated. You can put the chair back to where you had it originally, if you need it there for support. Just place it there. And before we finish now, I'm just asking you just to set the feet just nice and firm on the ground. Soft bend of the knees. And just to finish off now, I'll ask you just to reach all the way out in front. Okay, so we'll just give the upper back just a good stretch. And just hold that there. And then just bring both your hands and just place them at the base of your back, just in front of your hips. Okay. And then we're just going to try and squeeze our elbows together. And when we can go no further, we're just going to hold that there. Four, three, two, and one. And just relax it away. I'll ask you again then, just to reach both your hands out in front. And we're going to inhale, and as we exhale, we're going to turn to the right hand side. Okay, so we're going to inhale, big deep breath in. And exhale, turn. And hold the stretch there. Okay, inhale, and then we're going to turn on the exhale again. Great stuff. Inhale, exhale, turn. Holding your stretch. And inhale, turn on the exhale again. Excellent. From there then, I'll ask you just to take your hands again together in prayer. Point the elbows out to the side. And we're going to twist to the side. And hold. Three, two, and one. Back to the center and twist to the opposite side and hold. For three, two, and one. And back to center again. We're going to relax out the hands. Using your external or fixed support, I'll ask you just to place your right foot out behind, keeping the heel flat on the ground, and your left knee then, you're going to slowly move that away from you. Okay, ever so slightly. And when you feel that you can't move it anymore, and you feel a stretch in the back of your calf and the lower leg, you'll just hold it there. And again, chin up, looking straight ahead. And then we'll stand it up nice and tall, left foot out behind then, heel flat on the ground, and we'll gently move the front knee forward. Again, be mindful to keep that back heel flat on the ground. Three, two, and one. We'll stand it up nice and tall. Okay, we can shake out the feet. And our right heel then, we're just going to bring it up towards the bum, bring it up as high as we can, keeping both knees in line. And if you feel comfortable, you can grab the trouser leg, or indeed you can grab just the bottom of your leg as well. Just to lift it up that bit higher, to give you more of a stretch in front of your quad. Hold it there and slowly release back to the ground. Again, using your external support, We're lifting the heel up towards the bum, both knees in line, and if you feel ready then, you can lift it up that bit higher by using your trouser leg. And just hold the stretch there. 4, 3, 2, and 1, and slowly release back to the ground. And before we finish now, I'll just ask you again just to place both your hands back to back, slight bend of knees, and we're going to inhale in through the nose, lifting the hands high above the head. And exhale, hands down. Inhale. Exhale, hands down. And last one now, big deep breath in again, in through the nose. Blowing out through the mouth. And when you're ready, in your own time, no big rush, you can slowly just begin to open the eyes. Give yourself a clap or a pat on the back, folks. Well done. Great work today, as always. Liz, you're very welcome. And Jerry, as always, you're very welcome as well. So I hope you enjoyed that today, folks. And apologies for Monday. I believe we had some technical difficulties here on Monday, as is the danger, I suppose, of these live videos. So we had a session done. We had it recorded. And unfortunately, due to some technical difficulties, we were unable to put it out on Monday morning. So again, apologies for that on behalf of myself and Age&Opportunity. But we will be putting that up now on Friday at 11 a.m. So it's a nice seaside, a nice coastal seated session. So hope you can join us for that on Friday, sorry, at 11 a.m. If not, as always, you can watch it back either here or on YouTube as well. So thanks today again, folks. And it is off now to have the tea or the coffee or whatever you're having yourself. It's definitely well deserved this morning. That was a good session with plenty of tough movements, a lot of coordination and full body movements. So well done if you managed to do all of it. And again, you can watch it back at any time as well if you enjoyed it. Thanks again for joining us. Thanks for those that are watching back. I know there's a lot of people watching these videos back in the evening time, maybe when they have a bit more free time, so we appreciate that as well. So that's it for today, folks. You'll see me back here on Friday morning at 11 a.m. for our secret session. And also I'll be back again for another live secret session on Monday at 11 a.m. So until then, as always, you're very welcome, Kitty. Thanks a million for joining in. It's great to have you here. As always, stay active and stay well. Thank you very much.